Hi friends, I am back with our second session. In our previous session, we had discussed about the Modlingua Rubric and 10-point agenda and learned how to improve our content writing and minimize errors. Those errors can be minor as well as major. A careful study based on rubric was recommended for all the contents that you write. But apart from manual intervention, now we have many AI tools coming that help us. So today, out of many AI tools that we have in terms of grammar checkers, spell checkers, we also have sentence structure checkers. So out of many options, I have chosen one, and that is Grammarly. So today we are going to learn the usage of Grammarly, and in fine tune with Modlingua Rubric, we will see how Grammarly can help us in improve control of errors as per Modlingua Rubric. And at the same time, it also helps us to decrease the time of proofreading or quality control, and drastically improves the delivery. So let's start with our demonstration for today on Grammarly, number one. And after we have installed Grammarly, I will browse you through certain aspects of Grammarly and how it checks the text, and we'll see how things can improve after using Grammarly. So let's go to Google and give a search. I write Grammarly and see what happens. So here we have this Grammarly site, and what we have to do is we have to install Grammarly for Chrome. Okay, so now I will click on this link which is coming here, Grammarly for Chrome. And I will add this Add to Chrome extension here by clicking on Add to Chrome. It says as Grammarly for Chrome, add extension, it can read, write, whatever. You say yes, add. Now you see this has been installed in the right corner of our computer. Grammarly Chrome has been added to the Chrome. It's very automatic. It does very simple, installation, and it is not very complicated. After the installation is done, you will see this green button here, which is making, a round green shape with arrow mark in circle. And this is what is called Grammarly. So now once it has been installed, how do we check it? How do we use it? Generally, Grammarly, when you have installed it on Chrome, it will function online only. For example, if you are writing a message or writing a mail to somebody through Gmail or any online activity, it will check your spelling online. It will not be able to check your spelling, in MS Word file. For MS Word file, you have to install Grammarly for MS Word. In fact, Grammarly is number one. It has two options. One is paid option and another one is free option. So paid option is more, gives you more options of error corrections, deeper options. However, the free ones can also be used to control, errors like articles, punctuations, spaces, hyphen, commas, which is generally, one of the most important aspects of our content writing process, and many times we tend to over look those aspects. So even we are using free tools, of course you are free to add the paid version also in your computer, which will be very helpful. It will be worth paying as well. But to start with, let's start with our free version, and now in order to understand what our people have done, I will come back to our admin panel of my computer, I will just write, you know, one article here. Which you can also do from your, you know, system. So now let's say I want to add one article. I was referring, in fact, in our rubric, Modlingua Rubric, we have referred to the profiles as well as career goals of all our interns. So let's say I want to, you know, check one of the interns' profile, and that is Karina. Okay, so what I will do, I will go to my computer where I have saved all the profile of all our interns. And from there, I will pick up, you know, the profile of Karina, which we have discussed already about. And from there, I have, you know, I will copy paste this text. See, in our computers also, you know, we have a spell checkers like, you know, Word, MS Word file gives you options. For example, here, you know, red mark part, BA honors, again, red mark. Sales has, you know, some issues there. So you have to correct it, and sales it is recommending. Many times recommendations are wrong also, but you have to apply your wisdom. So now I will copy paste Karina's profile from here and bring it back to my panel where I'm plan to publish. Okay. So I have copy pasted here the content. Now what happens? Can you see, you know, the moment I have copy pasted these, this text, I have this article mistake, the second year in the French. After student, we need to have comma. French word, ignore. I want to do an internship myself in the corporate world. Franchisee, and since there is a, you know, mistake of space, again in the French, I got the third prize, my second goal, and then there is no comma needed. Yoga, you need comma. Water, and after water, you need comma, and nutrition. Israel, there is a mistake, you know, there is a additional comma added there, and that's it. So in a fraction of second for the growth of, okay. So even, you know, if French for 8 years. So since for the article comma, you know, we were able to correct it quite easily, you know, still it is recommending 23 deep, you know, corrections, you know, vacancies, forget about it. Myself to the corporate world, career goals, etc., etc. Now see, if it is also saying there are 23 advanced issues. So these 23 advanced, what are these advanced issues? It can be related to sentence structure. It can be related to plagiarism. There are certain two critical issues it is talking about. If you upgrade, you will be able to discover what are the problems, you know, deeper inside. However, from my point of view, after I have, you know, control these, you know, silly mistakes that we have just noticed, one can just give a final reading and approve it, you know, and then from there I will just save and publish. Okay, so just imagine if you submit, you know, your content after having gone through a proper quality control at your end, number one, which you will do manually, and at number two stage, deploy Grammarly or any of your choice of, you know, your AI tool. And after you have deployed that, do the correction parts, and then bring back. So this was, you know, a process of online using this tool. But if for some reason you are not able to, you know, do corrections online, what you can do is just go to Grammarly. And go to online. Here, this is called online editor. So instead of I had my own online platform, but if you don't have, you can come here, upload the text. You know, for example, I had this one. And then from here you check. After you have checked, copy paste, control A and control C, and then bring it back to your, you know, corrected version, back to Karina profile, do some formatting and copy and paste in the system where we have to submit your documents through online. Isn't it very simple? Give it a try, my friend. You will be able to improve quality of your work drastically, number one, and at the same time save your time as well as time of the editor and save time of our own system. So this way, if we apply, you know, our quality control process which we have developed through Modlingua Rubric and combine it with you know, artificial intelligence tools, you will be able to reduce the time gap in controlling quality control by half at least. So with this, I would like to thank you all for your time. Please watch this video. And if you have liked it, please do share, do subscribe, and be part of our community learning program. Hope to see you again in next session, which I'm planning to do on additional AI tools, which will be more useful for your improvement in content writing, translation, and editing.